If we get into HP mode, it will bring us in. We'll know where we are within a few inches in the world. These downward looking six help us to identify where we are in the lanes. We get different intensity readings off of paint lines and curbs, so we can tell where we are in the lane when we're riding down the street. Back. Couple more of these corner radars that we were talking about to see, help see what's around the vehicle. A good long distance radar, or to see what's behind us, and another little obstacle laser. And this is where the brains are.
Oh, wow.
Every car should have one. Every car should have one. I agree.
Yeah, what room?
What we're running with is 10 blades, these computer blades, and each one runs an Intel dual core processor. One way of looking at it is 20 laptops that would be running to help run the robot.
We can see why you didn't put it in a Malibu, though.
not a Mini?
No, this vehicle has served us very, very well. This,
I know that a lot of these are for data logging.
Yeah. So how hard would it be to put this package in to a smaller car?
Well, we've done is we've taken
what we're going to do. First thing you need to know is that this is an emergency stop button, so if you feel panicked or freaked out at any time, that'll stop the car. That means applying the brakes, coating the engine, everything. This green button is how we put it in manual mode. So right now it's in manual mode. The car drives just like any other car. You can hop in the driver's seat and drive. If you turn that clockwise, it'll pop up, and that makes it in autonomous mode. So when we're ready to go, I'll let you do that.
Oh,
I'll let
cool.
you just go
Philippe,
ahead.
You want to take the shot? You want to do it?
Go ahead.
I'm the GM guy, so you go ahead. You're the...
Break it.
All right.
And what you're going to see here is we have a little course set up here. Maybe you've seen it go around before. Yeah. So there's an intersection out there. There's another car driving out there. We'll interact with the other car at the intersection, so the vehicle should take precedence and should give precedence appropriately.
Right.
There's a couple of garbage cans sitting out there that we have, so the vehicle has to detect those and avoid those. And then just driving down the road and seeing, keeping from the hitting cones. And that's pretty much what we're going to see. So let me just make sure it's safe for us to launch. Hey, Rich, whenever the course is clear, if you could put us in the run, please.
Course looks clear, and you are in run right now, sir.
Okay, so now we're ready to go. Do you guys have any more questions before we get started?
Philippe?
We're good.
Good, okay. If you can twist that clockwise, we'll be on the right.
Okay,
can see this this display. We've actually detected the other car, and we're tracking it, and we're predicting all of the places that it might go. So we've detected that car and arrived before we did, so it's going to give them the right of way. It's kind of hard to see here, but it detects these garbage cans. There's the other garbage can.
How much time did it take to perfect this technology? How long has the team been working on this?
We built it in 18 months.
Really?
This was built in response to the DARPA Urban Challenge.
Okay.
So they announced it and then had the race 18 months later.